طباخ وحلويات بمطعم محل عندي.
I'm a pastry chef. I had a shop. Of course they blew up the shop. Two people were killed and my brother was wounded. My other brother has been detained since the conflict started. I lost all my money, my house. Nothing is left.
We fled during the bombing. My cousin was killed. Most of our relatives died. Almost half of our house was destroyed. After what they experienced during the bombing, my children are still frightened, even now. If they hear a door slam, they get scared and they start to cry and call out.
When the first heavy fighting began where we live in Homs, I continued to go to work. But it was difficult under the bombing and the gunfire. For those 4 months, we had no access to aid or assistance. If I didn't fear the bombing, I swear I would go back to Syria today and live on the rubble. It would be better than living in this humiliating situation.
The sanitary conditions in the camp are very bad. We have no sewage system, so we dig ditches. When it rains, the sewage runs between the tents. It can come inside or get very close to where people are living. The smell is affecting us, especially the children. They have rashes on their skin and they feel nauseous. When it rains, the tents are flooded and the children are always exposed to the cold. There are no stoves for heat. Most people don't have any wood, so they burn plastic to warm themselves. The situation is extremely dire.
This mat we are sitting on is wet with humidity. The health situation in the school is bad. The walls are wet. Everything is wet with humidity. You should see our mattresses. They are green with mold. My daughter caught the flu, of course. My 2-month-old baby has the flu now. He's been coughing a lot.
Our neighbors are the ones giving us food. When they cook, they give us some too. This is how we manage to eat, thanks to our neighbors. We also wash our children at the neighbors. In Syria, we feared the bombing. In Lebanon, we worry about how to get aid. We've received more aid from our neighbors than from aid organizations.
At home, the children had everything they needed. We never had to turn off the stove. The environment here is completely different for them.
We dug a well and used the well water for washing, but wastewater is flowing in. What we need the most here is medical care.